Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and I had the pleasure to be joined by Adam from Schecter Guitar Research USA. You already spoke us through the 2022 models upstairs in the show. If you haven't checked out that video, please give it a watch because it's amazing. But now we're in a candy land for me. This is the Schecter USA Custom Shop.
It's a lot of fun for everybody because everything that happens here literally starts off as a block of wood and gets made into a guitar. Yeah. So it's everything that you want to see from start to finish in this whole thing. You can see here, these are different body blanks that we have, different necks over here, different fingerboards, things like that.
All shapes and sizes. There's quilted maple, there's everything. Flame, there's everything.
You even got some of these up here, like our stabilized tops. Oh, these ones are really kind of cool to see.
Look at that.
There's all sorts of different colors and shapes, but we do a lot of these for tops, and a lot of times we'll even cut out the pieces of it to make bobbins for the pickups out of it.
Oh, really?
Match with it,
that's
coordinate.
Very cool.
These tops are really, really cool. They're all stained and filled in like that. Just one of the things. You got koa, you've got all sorts of fun stuff, but this is where all this stuff starts at, right here.
So how many guitars do you reckon on a monthly basis do you guys?
We make about 40 a month or so. There's different levels of it. There's what you have, like your USA production and custom shop stuff, and then you have our masterwork stuff. So the USA production, as you'll see, is these blocks of wood. They get CNC'd, hand sanded and built, everything like that. And then you have masterworks where we literally have Tetsu, this one luthier who's
sitting
there.
In his little corner there, just crafting away.
He's got a chisel and he just hand carves everything, and it's some of the most immaculate things you've ever seen. And just really fun and cool to look at. But we'll head over that way and show you that as well.
Oh, definitely. So where do we go from here, man?
So, actually, this is perfect, as you guys can see. This is the CNC machine right here that's going to give us our basic body shape for it. This is Drew. Drew's the one that runs all this stuff and programs all this and makes everything run this way. What have you got going on right here?
These are two of our Tread Wembley tubes. Kind of a, they get the aged finish. Kind of like a, it's kind of a mix between like a modern, it's got a compound radius, roasted neck and everything, but kind of vintage finish. They're pretty popular.
If you guys want to take a closer look here at what we got going on, you can see it actually cutting the arm bevel on the top right now too. So what you see here with all the CNC stuff, like again, that gives you kind of the basic body shape. Like, there you go. So as you can see here, once it comes off, it's not good to go. It's not perfect in what it is. It gives us our basic shape, but you can actually see where that bit goes by on each pass. So once it's done here, it still has to be hand sanded and shaped. There's a lot of hands-on that goes into this once we get this basic, like, blank, if you will.
Yeah, is the grain specifically chosen as well for each kind of guitar? Or, like, if it's a see-through top, will you pick some specific grain?
Yeah, we just with bodies and tops and everything, if there's a transparent finish or anything,
you'll specifically choose the nice grain. Very cool.
We'll try to pick the nicer looking stuff for that. And,
but with that, will that one be a transparent top? Because that's a beautiful grain regardless. But that,
one actually is not. It's a solid.
So that just proves the caliber of the stuff you've got anyways. Even the stuff that's covered is still really good.
Yeah, I mean, we're pretty picky about it, and if we have something, you know, stuff will come out in the middle sometimes, and we can't control it. And
if we
can't use it, we can't. You know, we'll find a. We experiment on that stuff later.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Find something else to do with it.
Very cool. Well, thanks for showing us, man. Amazing.
Yeah.
So where do we go once the
orders are here? We'll do all the hand sanding.
Thank you, mate. Cheers.
So like we were explaining before, when these things come off the CNC, you can feel where that bit goes by. Like, feel that right there. So you can feel it, where each part goes by. Now this isn't, you know, an insanely misshapen neck whatsoever.
Yeah.
But once they go from there, they come over here where everything's hand sanded and shaped, and you get something that feels like that.
Oh wow. Yeah, that's.
I wish you guys could feel it through the camera, but it's a huge difference. There's a lot of time that goes into this. These guys do all the bodies, as you can see right here. They do a lot of the necks. Everything is all to get this thing to be as flawless as possible, especially before it goes into paint, because any little imperfection, once you paint over it, it just magnifies it 10 times.
Dedication to the cause as well, because if you ever sanded anything, it's quite hard to do after a period of time.
And
every time I try and do something, I always end up being like, oh, it'll do. It'll do, because your hands are sore by the end, but these are all perfect.
These guys do this all day long. They really know what they're doing.
So they
they've been practicing. They've done one or two at least.
So. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. But this is where all the shaping goes into this. And this has to do with like our USA production stuff. So again, yes, they do come off the CNC. You get that basic shape here. But everything that you're going to feel, that comfort and that extra level, it all comes from the hand sanding and everything that they're doing right here.
Amazing.
It's incredible.
A small operation you got here as well.
It's yeah.
Very, very close to that kind of thing.
It's very small, but it allows us to keep that level of, you know, perfection a little bit higher because you can monitor things a lot better. So.
Like we were saying about the CNC machine earlier today, because we actually chatted to Michael, the president of Schecter, about all this kind of stuff. The CNC stuff just makes, well, the Schecter have a high level anyways. Like you have to kind of get to that with all the custom shop stuff. So that just gives you kind of the precision to be consistent with the perfection that you desire.
If you're hand carving every single body, then that number goes from 40 way down to like 2.
But you're saying the master stuff is...
I'll show you the master. That's all by hand over here. That's what Tetsu does. It's amazing stuff. It's super cool to watch, so...
Very nice.
We'll get over to that in a second.
Yes, what's next on this production line?
We should head over here to paint.
Let's do it.
Next, it comes over here and everything gets painted. This is Chewy. He's our painter. He's incredible. He does lots of really great work. He's doing some clear coats right now on this stuff, but he does everything that you see here. Everything comes through here. He's the one that paints it all.
Yeah.
So, again, super high attention to detail on this stuff. You got one guy who...
I see them glistening through the window. They're looking fantastic.
It's just like a donut. It's like a glazed donut.
For sure. That's the best way to describe him.
Yeah, but we have tons of different things that goes through here. He does it all. He's been doing it for years.
He's quite a famous name in the guitar painting world, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. He's painted one or two guitars for
one or two very, very
couple,
special guitars.
Couple famous people.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And you've got him here in the Schecter Custom Shop.
Yep.
Nice guy to nail down.
We're very lucky to have him, that's for sure.
Nice. So once the painted,
they come over here and you can see all the buffing that we do.
Nice.
Yeah, so once they're done painting all the stuff, it comes out here, there's tons of buffing and sanding and buffing and rebuffing and buffing some more, and then making sure all these finishes are pretty much flawless on that. They go in and out multiple times. It's very tedious and cumbersome, but they nail this kind of stuff.
They get a very small operation still.
Yeah, absolutely.
For how popular Schecter are around the world, everyone knows the custom shop. I was expecting more, but it's really cool to see such a small operation producing some amazing guitars, some of the best guitars.
Yeah, and like I said, I think keeping it small like this, we're able to control a lot of more things, and it makes it awesome.
Everyone knows what everyone's doing, and everyone knows where they are on the line,
Actually, let's see if we can get something over here we can pull out. Ah. So this is probably what he's doing in there right now. You can see the same kind of top. This one's got the red burst on it.
Yeah.
All the dust on it from the buffing wheel on it. Comes right off, but
very cool.
So this is one of the things you see the sound.
That's yet to guess.
They will sand it. They will buff it. They will sand it. They will buff it. They will reshoot it. They'll sand it. I couldn't even tell you how many times they do it. It's a million. They'll make sure that it's flawless, though. Promise you that.
Unbelievable. Hell yeah, man. The natural binding as well. You guys see natural binding is such a beautiful way. If you're not sure, like it's not a regular binding with these things. They literally tape off, don't you, essentially, the outside and paint the guitar. So you get the flame label as the binding.
Yep.
As opposed to just painting some binding on or taping binding on. It's really cool.
Yeah.
It's really cool.
Yeah, it's really awesome. But I'll show you guys the masterworks and some assembly stuff next.
Yes, let's do that, man.
Cool.
So Adam, we're now in quite an incredible part of the custom shop. Where are we right now?
So this right here is all the masterwork stuff. Yeah. So as you saw before, everything else was a USA production and custom stuff. This custom shop kind of stuff where you see it go through the CNC machine, all the hand sanding, everything else like this. Everything over here is 100% done by hand.
Yeah.
So this is our masterworks. This is done by Tetsu. Everything here you'll see is cut by hand, sanded by hand, shaped by hand, pieced together by hand.
He's a legend in himself as well. He's done some amazing work over here.
He's been practicing a little bit. He's been doing a good job. But here you can see some of the ones that he's done. Again, this is all done by hand by one person. So these are just some incredible different works that he's done, different necks, everything again pieced together by hand. Some of these with the actual wooden tuners.
Yep. Wow.
Wooden saddles and bridges. And
because why not?
Yeah.
If you can.
I always thought this was cool. Here's something that he shaped out with cardboard first.
Oh, wow.
Kind of get the shape for it.
Right, dimensions and stuff,
And then you can see the actual wood one there. So. He did a pretty good job.
Got a little kind of performance flame on the go. This V is stunning.
Yeah, a lot of this stuff he'll even take and kind of piece together after different scraps and stuff like that. These are made over from Merrow necks.
That's incredible.
Necks, just some different things like that, but everything here you see is just by hand, next level stuff for them.
So interesting. Can we actually see him working on some stuff?
Let's see if he's got anything going on.
Let's have a little look.
Yep, but this would be where they do all the masterwork stuff right here. This is Tetsu.
Hello.
But yeah, everything here is done 100% by hand. And you can see he's working on a neck right here. But all these are just him and his idea and everything else that he does there.
Amazing work, mate. Amazing.
He's been practicing. He's doing all right. Yeah, so like as we were saying before, the masterwork stuff is all done by hand. You can actually see, this is the pin router that we actually used to make the Prince symbol guitar that was all made by Tatsu as well.
Yeah, you might have seen the background of the previous videos, like looking at the 2022 stuff, the symbol guitar on the background. Before Prince's unfortunate passing, you guys were in charge of the cloud guitar, the Prince guitar, the symbol guitar, and it was all made here in this corner of the workshop on that router.
Exactly, so it was all done by him, by hand, but that was probably one of the most epic Masterworks builds that we did by far.
Oh, without a shadow of a doubt, it's an unbelievable place to be.
Absolutely.
And it's all in the same workshop as the USA Custom Shop stuff.
Yep, and actually I can show you where we do the rest of the assembly stuff too.
Let's do that, yeah, it's a great idea. So here we are in final assembly, where everything we've just seen out there comes together. It's a magical little place.
Yeah, what's cool is everything you guys saw out there is just to get the individual pieces all together. Mm-hmm. Everything comes in here, and this is where it gets assembled and put together by our good friend Shigeki right here. Mm-hmm. He puts all of it together by himself. Well, he's got one little helper in the corner.
Dressing for us in the corner.
But everything is just done by these two guys right here. So again, that attention to detail, the level
small,
that we get.
Yeah, small intimate scale is very apparent.
Shigeki's done a really great job with putting everything together. He's done one or two guitars.
He's shaking his head, he's humble.
He's very knowledgeable. He's my best friend in the whole world. He loves me more than anybody else here. He says it all the time. But what is this one right here?
The Sunset 24.
So this is a Sunset 24.
It's absolutely stunning. Together. Check that out, guys. It's a beautiful thing. The matching flame on the headstock as well. Jesus, the attention to detail is crazy in this place.
But yeah, again, this is where everything gets put together. As you can see, there's some different bodies that we have here too. Different things they're working on. Chambered one there. But amazing. We should check out the
Let's check out this little room in the corner here.
The coolest one.
Oh, and I'm losing my mind right now. Yeah, absolutely losing my mind. So, under good authority here.
So this was a replica one. This was the actual Prince one, I believe. So you can see. On the back of it, you got all the nice little buckle rash and everything, but
oh my God.
If you want to feel it, go for it.
Custom built by Schecter Guitar Research, Los Angeles, California. This is absolutely insane. If you're aware of this channel and how I play guitar, Prince is a huge influence of me, so this got sent here to fit a Floyd Rose on just before Prince's passing, and it's just stayed here ever since, I guess. You guys did a little custom run with Paisley Park, didn't you?
Yep.
After his passing as a little tribute, but this is actually Prince's guitar.
That was his, sent that back quite a bit to get some repairs as he would toss that thing around on stage like you wouldn't believe.
Oh, he's an intense dude. So he's an intense, it's very nicely balanced.
Yeah.
It's absolutely crazy. Unbelievable, what an end to an amazing tour of this incredible Sherwin factory. Thank you so much, Adam.
Thanks for coming,
it's
appreciate
an absolute
you guys.
Pleasure. And yeah, if you don't mind, I'm gonna go and sit in the corner and just quietly just play Pitbull Rain to myself.
Take it home with you.
Cheers, thanks guys.